here live from Book Expo America 2014 in New York City. And our guest right now is author Anne Girard, who's written the untold story of Eva Gouel, who stole the heart of Pablo Picasso. Welcome, Anne.
Thank you for having me.
This story takes us from the salon of Gertrude Stein to the glamorous Moulin Rouge and inside the studio and heart of history's most influential artist, Pablo Picasso. Where did you start when researching this story?
Oh, goodness. Well, a little bit with art, obviously. I love art and the lives of artists and that sort of thing. And I already had a little bit of a background, a little bit of a knowledge of Picasso, and really just looked at his life and the women involved. And his love affair with her just really stood out for me. So it was just a story that needed telling. And I feel like their love affair really hasn't been explored historically or in fiction.
This is a unique glimpse into Picasso's life and loves. What was the most interesting or surprising thing that you discovered while researching the story?
Probably how much he truly did love her and his great passion for her. I think that historically he somewhat has become somewhat of a caricature, this brooding
bit of a womanizer.
Yes, exactly. And I think during that period of his life, he truly was vulnerable with her and he truly did love her. I think that it was probably the great passion of his life. And I believe that he really never completely recovered from it, just from the research I did. You know, he went on in his life. But I do think it really marked the rest of his life.
Interesting. Eva's torrid affair with Picasso, she evolves from his muse to his greatest love, as you say. In the course of the story, she meets Picasso's mistress, Fernande. Could you talk a little bit about the similarities and differences between these two ladies?
I think the only thing that I would say that would be similar about them was that they were both, at different times, they were both completely passionate and in love and devoted to Picasso. I think that as women, well, they were both strong as well, but I think they were completely different, which is what really drew him and attracted him. I think that Fernande was very emotional and tempestuous, and Eva was a little bit more calm, a calming influence in his life. So I think there are more differences than similarities.
She also seemed to understand at a visceral level what he was trying to accomplish with his art.
I agree.
Mm-hmm. What lessons do you think that a modern woman from today can take from the story?
Being a little bit of committed to your love affair and committed to the person that you, your partner, but also she had an inner strength, pursued her own life and her own career and her own goals. And I think that made her more attractive to him. You know, she wasn't just at home waiting for him. Fernand was not as strong in that way. She really didn't have a career, didn't strive for that.
How much fun was it to breathe life into some of the famous characters from the Moulin Rouge?
Oh my gosh, love it. That's my favorite thing in the world to do. And I was able, over the summer, I was actually able to go to France and meet with Picasso's last living dear friend. They were friends for over 30 years. And so to speak to him about Picasso and, you know, ask him questions about Picasso, the man, beneath what we all, like I said earlier, what we all think of Picasso, just to hear a little bit of the human side of him. So I hope I was able to put some of that into the story. That certainly was what my goal.
I find it really interesting that Picasso is seen as a man's man, and yet so much of who he became as both an artist and a celebrity is influenced by the women in his world.
Absolutely, absolutely. So they were probably his, you know, his greatest, I don't know, I was going to say bonus, but also his greatest curse, because when the relationships ended, a lot of times they were very bitter and very angry, which is what his friend said to me. You know, most of them ended up with, you know, tell-all books and things like that, which really contributed to his kind of the negative view a lot of people have of him now. So hopefully I would like to think that I changed that a little bit, the perspective, and maybe added a little of the humanness of the man.
So what are you working on next?
I am working on a book about Jean Harlow, the early years of Jean Harlow. It's called Platinum Doll, and I'm very excited to be doing that. I haven't done a book in the United States, set in the United States, for a while, so being able to do that is a nice new challenge for me.
Sounds fascinating. Thank you so much for sitting down with us today, and best of luck with Madame Picasso.
Thank you so much.